Hari Om. Now today's subject is yoga for diabetes. Diabetes also is very common disease and it is growing in fast speed. And medicine is not the proper solution for that. Of course, medicine works for it. It is essential also. But we cannot cure the diabetes with medicine. That is the problem. We can control. If sugar level is very high, it can be controlled immediately with medicine. But medicine is to be taken continuously up to the end of the life. This indicates that diabetes can be controlled with medicine, but not cured with the medicine. Because requirement of medicine doesn't stop at all. It goes on increasing. And finally, the patient has to take a direct insulin with the injection. But with the help of yoga, we can cure diabetes. It means the sugar will be normal without any medicine. And it will remain normal. So medicine can be stopped totally. That is the result of yoga. That is why yogic treatment is very, very important. As you know, higher sugar level is indication of diabetes. I am using the proper word. It is an indication of diabetes. Higher sugar level is not a diabetes. Because sugar level fluctuates in our body. If you take more sweets and sugar directly and all, sugar level goes up. But that is not a patient of diabetes. That sugar level is maintained by body. If sugar is excess in the blood, it is stored in the liver in the form of glycogen. It is there in the blood in the form of glucose. So excess sugar is stored in liver, so sugar level remains normal. And suppose we don't take food for a long time, the sugar level in the blood is reduced. And then of course the stored sugar in liver is poured in bloodstream. This function is autonomous nervous system. So again sugar level is maintained. So sugar level fluctuates depending on our food and depending on the consumption of sugar through the exertion. And it is maintained normal. Then what is diabetes? Diabetes is that normal level is not maintained properly in the body. Then it is diabetes. That means sugar level remains higher only. And the main reason is secretion of insulin. That secretion is not as per the requirement of the body. Normally it is less. And that is why the sugar level remains high in diabetic patient. The details have been already explained to you, so I don't want to go in more details of this. But the main function which I want to focus is the function of pancreas, which creates insulin. Insulin is a hormone. So the main cause of diabetes is not just the high sugar level, but the proper creation of insulin. And insulin is created in pancreas. So we have to focus on pancreas. Focus on function of pancreas and correct that. Maintaining sugar level is just managing the symptom. But if you are in particular yogic practices, they improve the function of pancreas. And that is why the sugar level remains normal. When the function of pancreas is managed properly with the yogic practices, then we can say that is a cure of diabetes. not only control. So why these pancreas are not producing proper insulin? Because they have become sluggish. Because insulin is to be produced throughout the life. So after a long time, they may become sluggish. And why? The main reasons are, the first is stress. Stress is affecting the function of each and every organ of our body. Similarly, here also, stress is affecting the function of pancreas. So pancreas become sluggish. They don't produce proper insulin. And the sugar level is not managed. And then it is diabetes. Then there is a low blood supply to pancreas, of course, because blood gives proper glucose, oxygen, and all food nutrients. When blood supply is less, all this is less. Even pancreas cells, they need also glucose, and that is supplied through the blood. So if blood supply is low, pancreas function can become sluggish. Then there is a low nerve supply. Nerve supply is a very typical words we can use. Actually, every cell of our body is controlled by brain through nervous system. Similarly, the pancreas cells, that means the beta cells, they produce insulin. They are controlled by brain through the nervous system. And that is called nerve supply, because there are sensory nerves who take the message from the cells to the brain, and there are motor nerves, they give the order of the brain to the cells. So this communication is called nerve supply. If this communication is not proper, still the pancreas can't produce better insulin as required. And the fourth one is a mental block. Because mind is there and it is controlling the whole body through brain. If mind is not proper, then it will not be able to control brain also properly. And brain also will not be able to control pancreas properly. And that will result in diabetes. So these are the main reasons why the pancreas becomes sluggish. I had discussed all these points because we have to focus on those reasons, not only on sugar level. And we have to manage the stress, blood supply, nerve supply, and mental block also. The stress we can manage with definitely, of course, the yoga nidra, om chanting, and meditation. Blood supply we can manage with the practice of asanas particularly. And nerve supply we can manage with the pranayamas. So for all these reasons, we have got specific yogic practices. And that is what I will be discussing hereafter. We must locate the position of pancreas, because we have to select the asanas, we have got the effect on this particular pancreas. So you can see in this picture, left side is liver and right side is stomach. Of course, you are left and right, not the persons. And pancreas is just below the stomach. Long one, you can observe there. So this is below the stomach and above the diaphragm. So this location you must remember, and accordingly we'll select the asanas which have its effect on this particular location, that is on pancreas. That is very important. So our regular training program will be in a normal fashion. First we'll start with the preparatory practices, then selected yogi useful asanas, then cleansing practices, pranayama, meditation, yoga nidra, contraindications, and food recommendations. Preparatory practices, as usual, we have to start with Shavasana, minimum 3 minutes. Because the person is new, the diabetes patient is totally new. He has never practiced yoga and asanas and all that. So we have to start with Shavasana, that is normal case. Then you can start with the basic movements from Yoga Sopan book. These basic movements and the preparatory movements from Yoga Pravesh book also. They will loosen all the joints, remove the excess stress, tension, and they will develop the flexibility. These preparatory practices are not for diabetes. These are for preparation of the body and mind of the patient. So afterwards, they may not be needed. Then we can add sun salutation also with slow speed. Because afterwards we have to increase the speed. But to start with, it is with a slow speed as we teach in Yoga Pravesh course. And the Pavan Muktasan series from APMB book. Satyananda. These are the preparations. These are not directly connected with diabetes and functioning of pancreas and all. But the useful practices, these are very, very important now. I am repeating preparatory movements, type 1 to 10, but with fast speed. As a preparatory practices, we taught them with normal and slow speed. But as a useful practices, we have to teach with fast speed, up to 4 times. Of course, slowly, slowly we have to teach, not suddenly. This is a normal point that I am giving the targets, which are to be achieved in different steps slowly. Same case with sun salutation. Our normal speed is 1 minute for one round. It is recommendation is 32 rounds in 8 minutes. That is again 4 times. So fast preparatory practices, fast sun salutations. This is exercise. This is not yoga, but it is exercise, but it works for a diabetic patient, because it stimulates the functioning of pancreas to produce proper insulin. That is why I recommended this type of exercise. And it is a useful practice. This is to be repeated every day. Then I am giving the list of asanas. These are to be practiced on level 3 and 4 with concentration of mind on pancreas. Now this you level 3 and 4. It means attaining the asana position with very, very slow speed. Then relax all the muscles of the body as much as possible. This is very important. If you don't relax the muscles, the pancreas will not get stress or compression and it will have no effect of asanas. Then concentrate the mind on pancreas. That is also very important. So we can provide the mental energy also to the pancreas to produce proper insulin. And maintain the asana position for some time as long as it is comfortable. That varies from person to person, patient to patient. And finally, release the asana position with very, very slow movement. This is level 3 and 4. That means relaxation after attaining the position is also very important. And focusing the mind on the pancreas is also important. And for that, you need to explain the position of pancreas to the patient in his or her body so that the patient will be able to focus his mind on the pancreas. So we'll providing the mental energy also. So this level 3 and 4 is important. If you practice asanas on only level 1 or 2, it will have no effect for the diabetes. The patient may get the results of those asanas, no doubt. But there will be no effect on pancreas. So there is no improvement in condition of diabetes. So level 3 and 4 is important. Normally in every book, number of asanas are given. Total list is given. But they don't specify how to do the asanas. That's why I specifically recommend them, particularly for diabetes, that these asanas are to be practiced. And once you understand this technique, then selection of asana is not so difficult. Again, you have to focus on location of pancreas, and accordingly you have to select the asanas. So Uttana Pada Chakrasana, 3 rounds. Again, this is target. You should not ask them to practice on the first day only. First day maybe only 1 round. But slowly go on increasing as per the capacity of the patient. Then Dhanurasana, 3 rounds, 1 minute each. Again, this is target. This is not first day program. Then Ashwini Mudra in Sarvangasana to maintain for 3 minutes at level 3 and 4. Halasana 1 minute, Matsyasana 30 seconds. Ardha Matsyanarasana 2 minutes on each side, Paschimottanasana 1 minute. All these asanas on level 3. Akarna Dharunasana 1 minute on each side, Udara Sanchalan 3 rounds, Halasana or Mayurasana, 3 rounds each. Because this is giving good pressure on the pancreas. That's why every time you have to remember position of pancreas in the body. And then you think of the asanas. Then you will definitely understand how these asanas are effective for diabetes. Parivarta Trikonasana, 1 minute on each side. Virasana, 1 minute on each side. Of course, Shavasana. Now let us think of the cleansing practices. These are also very important. But these are not important to clean the body, but important for controlling the functions of pancreas. Agnisar, 100 strokes, total 3 to 4 rounds. Maybe 5-6 rounds also at the beginning. This is the ultimate target. Udyan Bandha for 5 rounds, each round 30 seconds. Kapalbhati also 5 rounds, 120 strokes per round. Navli, all types. Because these are all connected with the function of pancreas. Then Vaman Dhauti also is recommended once a week. Full Shankha Prakshalan once a year. But followed by Laghu Shankha Prakshalan for 40 days. This is a specific recommendation given by Swami Satyanand Saraswati in his book. We tried also. It gives good effect. Quite good improvement in the function of pancreas. That means Shankha Prakshalan once a year, and followed by, you have to keep 1 or 2 days gap in between, and then start Laghu Shankha Prakshalan, short, every day for 40 days. This is a very nice recommendation. Pranayama, of course, we have to stimulate the function of pancreas. That is a stimulating pranayamas. It is a Surya Bedan with Kumbhak for 10 minutes, Bhastrika Pranayam with Kumbhak for 10 minutes. Now when we have to teach Kumbhak, before that we have to teach Bhatri Bandhas, Jalandhara Bandha, Udyan Bandha, Mula Bandha. And before that we have to teach Anulom Vilom, that is Shuddhi Pranayam. So this sequence has to be followed. You should not teach directly Surya Bedan or Bhastrika. Because when I recommend with Kumbhak, 3 bandhas are also very, very essential. That is why you have to teach bandhas, and teaching bandhas will take a long time. And of course, Nadi Shodhan Pranayam or Anulom Vilom we have to teach before. That is also very important. So this preparatory work, you have to adjust yourself. It is not given in this. Now Yoga Nidra, it is better to design a specific Yoga Nidra for diabetes. Because we have to remove the mental block. No, mental block in a sense, what happens? The diabetic patient takes medicines maybe for years together, not getting proper cure. So he is changing some medicines, changing some doctors. He may change the pathies also. He may take Ayurveda also. Allopathy also, homeopathy also, and all that. But still, he is not getting relief. So, there is a thought in his mind fixed that his diabetes is not going to cure. And doctors also suggest like that only. So, he has got a fixation in the mind that diabetes is not going to cure. So it becomes a mental block. When mind is not accepting anything, body will not accept, and the effect of yogic practices will not be there unless we clear this mental block. And for clearing this mental block, specific design yoga nidra is very essential. When the person starts practicing yoga nidra, his mental block gets cleared. His mind accepts, yes, your diabetes can be cured by yogic practices. Then mind accepts, body also accepts, and he gets improvement. As long as this block is not removed, improvement even with the yogic practices also is not possible. Of course, you don't have specially designed yoga nidra for diabetes, then you can use yoga nidra for stress relief. That will not give the proper result, but it is effective to some extent. Then meditation on Manipur chakra. Because the pancreas is governed by Manipur chakra, by location also and by function also. So Manipur chakra meditation, how to teach and all that we already explained before. And mantra is Om Ram. So while meditating, the person should chant Om Ram, Om Ram, Om Ram like that. Of course, minimum 30 minutes. Yoga Nidra also 30 minutes. And this to practice every day. Now the optional practice, it can be anything. But whatever I suggested up till now, useful practices are very, very important. Those must be taught. But optional practices, if required, they can be suggested and taught afterwards. Bhujangasana, Naukasana, Viparit Karani, Vakrasana, Uttanapadasana, Pavan Muktasana, Ardha Paschimottanasana, Ustrasana, Garudasana, Trikonasana, Patangasana, Shirshasana, all its variations, so much. Pranayamas also, Anulom Vilom, with or without Kumbhak, right nostril breathing. They are stimulating, so that can be added. Cleansing practices, Jalneti, Danda Dhoti, Vastra Dhoti and all that. Now when I have suggested all these asanas, high speed Surya Namaskar, fast speed reparative movements, there you have to consider the condition of a patient. It means I assume that patient is pure diabetic patient. He is not having any other complication. Diabetic patient with blood pressure, he cannot do many things. Diabetes patient with heart problem, he can't do all these asanas and pranayamas. Diabetic patient with slip disc, also very complicated. So such cases are very, very difficult to treat, and I recommended that you should not treat complicated cases. What I explain is for pure case means there is only diabetes, otherwise the patient is quite healthy. No other medical problem. Everything is okay. And only diabetes is there. For such patients, I prescribe all these things. If some complication is there, then lot of changes can take place. And this combination permutation is very large. We cannot discuss all that combination permutation. That is why every patient we have to discuss all these points in the beginning. What complications are there, what are not there and all that. And for the pure case of diabetes, we can suggest all these yogic practices and then he can improve. Because of some complications, some practices cannot be practiced. So the patient may take longer time. And some practices have to be permanently stopped for that particular patient. So this becomes little bit complicated case. Contraindications as such, they are not there. But at least we can say Shitali Shitkali Pranayam is not suitable. So with that we can avoid and left nostril breathing. Otherwise for asanas there is no contraindication. food habits, normal food habits we have to suggest definitely. But again, sugar, sugarcane, rice, that is, carbohydrates are to be controlled and limited. And in many cases, diabetic patient is, they are having overweight also. So you have to control the weight also. So accordingly, I recommended food habits here. At least fat, carbohydrate, but with high fibers. Best food is of course fruits, but except banana, mango, grape, because they put on the weight, direct sugar. But vegetables are very good and effective. Then avoid sugar, sugarcane, non-veg food, milk and milk product, rice, because it is concentrated carbohydrate. It increases the glucose in the blood. In oily and spicy food, refined food, fast food, preserved food, everything is to be avoided. This is a very special program. It is called FOFOR. These are the initials of Sanskrit word. It's a 3-day program, continuously 3 days. First day, the patient should take only fruits and raw vegetables. Boiled vegetables will do, but there should be no addition to that. All these spicy, no. Just boil, add some salt and its salt. Then second day also same. Only fruits and raw vegetables. And no other food should be taken. No normal food. Only fruits and vegetables. Raw or boiled, that's all. And third day, all juices, fruit juice and soups. But of course without sugar. We can call it as a liquid diet. So this is successive 3 days. This is called FOFOR. This is very good for diabetic patient. And with this food, sugar level immediately comes down. So we have to take care. We have to manage. Mostly we don't advise to take any medicine during these 3 days. Of course, that will depend on the patient and the condition of the patient. And this can be practiced in every 15 days. So 3 days in 15 days. It can be repeated continuously also. Every 3 days in 15 days. So this is very good and effective. Now it's some important guidelines. Continue the medicines of the patient as it is in the beginning. So patient comes with medicines definitely. He's taking medicine, maybe some pathy, some doctor and whatever it is. And he's getting some relief with that medicine. So let it continue. Don't stop the medicine. That is my regular and normal suggestion. So continue the medicine, but monitor the sugar level. Means measure, go on measuring in the laboratory, of course, or if you got a machine, you can measure with the machine also. So monitor the sugar level and ask the patient to contact his or her physician for adjusting the treatment accordingly. You cannot modify the treatment. You are not authorized to manage the treatment because you are not a doctor. It's a ethical rule and legal also. You can suggest to the patient, let's check sugar level. If it is less, you ask him to show the report to his physician. And that physician will definitely reduce the medicine. So medicine will go on reducing step by step. But monitoring the sugar level and instructing the patient is your duty. Not the managing the medicine. That will be done by the physician. And when the course is complete, you have to give a daily practicing program to the patient and ask him or her to continue, because continued practice is also very important. Short-term practice will give short-term results. Continued practice will give continued results. So that suggestion also is very important. So likewise, if you follow all these instructions, definitely a patient is going to improve. And after some time, the medicine will be totally stopped. Sugar level will be perfectly normal even after eating sugar. That is a proper situation for a diabetic patient. And you definitely can achieve this, provided if you follow all the instructions given by me. Hari Om.
This minute, a second.